This one is really interesting. Dan, what do we have for 61 here?
Proposition 61.
It's the state prescription drug purchases pricing standards.
I knew that.
Initiative statute.
I knew that. Here we go. Found it. Prop 61 is the drug price standard, so requires the state pay the same or lower price for pharmaceutical drugs as is done by the U.S. Department of Veterans Affairs, which pays the lowest drug prices of any government agency.
And speaking of the two of you's favorite person, Senator Bernie Sanders was on Real Time with Bill Maher last night, and he gave a very impassioned bit about it.
Well, full disclosure, Dr. Bill and I originally met at Philadelphia in July, which is not coincidentally because it was also the Democratic National Convention. Dr. Bill and I were both delegates for Bernie Sanders.
Bernie Bros. Bernie delegates.
I've been fighting the Bernie Bros stigma so hard, and then you just brought it
Bernie
down,
Bros.
Just ruined it.
But none other than the California Bernie delegation.
Yes.
Right? The rabble rousers.
Yeah, people loved us. Yeah.
So tell me about this, because I think I'm going to assume we're all on the same page here, but what are your thoughts on it?
Well, the Prop 61 is absolutely progress in the fight for healthcare justice. And that's why Bernie's solidly supporting it. That's why the nurses are supporting it. The California Nurses Association, National Nurses United, is probably the strongest advocate for single-payer Medicare for All, an enhanced and improved Medicare for All, which probably does more on the insurance side than on the pharmaceutical side. So this proposition in California pulls in the pharmaceutical companies, and they were actually left out in the negotiation running up to Obamacare. So again, this recognizes California as a big dog, as a big player. We're talking, I believe it's $3.5 billion in pharmaceutical purchases for our state agencies, for Medi-Cal itself, for county hospitals, county employees, retirees, all of those groups. That constitutes a big dog in the market for pharmaceuticals. So you have other groups that negotiate, like the VA hospital, like Kaiser, for example. They negotiate with these big pharmaceutical companies as well, and as such can bring down the price, the actual price to consumers, with that kind of bulk purchasing power.
Yeah.
And this proposition sets as the standard what they're already doing from the VA system. So that's that will say that California wants to be considered like the VA, to be a large purchaser, and therefore you need to negotiate with us on that standard the same as you do for the VA hospital.
Now, the pharmaceutical companies, all of them are against this proposition.
Surprise.
All of them. This is big pharma money involved. One of their main arguments that I've been hearing a lot is that this proposition would hurt veterans by increasing prescription drug prices for them. So they're saying if California ties itself to the Department of Veteran Affairs, then the pharmaceutical companies will make the Veterans Affairs people pay more. Is there validity to that?
No.
I love your answers.
So great.
Can we hang out daily? Because that's,
you know, and they hit the airwaves early with some paid off of veterans groups. These are bought off veterans group, like the American Foreign Legion, like American Legion and Veterans of Foreign Wars. We haven't even heard from those groups on anything substantial in the last, you know, two or three decades.
Yeah.
The ones you hear about now are the veterans of Iraq and Afghanistan wars, and they're solidly in favor of this because a lot of the vets, as we know, have to purchase drugs outside of the VA system because of the way that the VA system exists. So, they're wrong, especially because this makes California a big player in the marketplace for pharmaceuticals. And that means it's going to drive down the price, not up the price, because if the pharmaceutical companies go up on the price, people will turn elsewhere. They're already going to Mexico and Canada to purchase drugs. As we know, living here in Southern California, so many people do go down to Mexico, down to Tijuana for medications or dental services.
Which reminds me, when you were in Mexico City, I forgot to ask you to get me more Propecia.
You know, it's funny. That's a joke, but
no, I actually would like to get more Propecia. I use the generic, which I don't know if it's a
use Propecia.
Effective. Yeah,
it works for you. I should
thank you.
I should
try some of that. No, you look great. You wear it well.
I couldn't tell. Actually, people legitimately asked me. They're like, "Hey, can you find out how much blah 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 costs?" And I'm like, "Whatever." You're gonna walk into CVS or CVS and just ask them like how much is Viagra? Like, you know what I mean? Like. But yes, it's true. And last night, Bernie Sanders was said that in 1985 or whenever it was, he took a busload of women up to Canada from Vermont
to get breast cancer medicine. I mean, it's like Michael Moore taking people to Cuba to buy inhalers, simple, asthma inhalers at 25 cents a piece compared to $25 a piece for an inhaler.
I heard... Oh, please.
Oh, one more thing. I'd just like to, because I am an ER doctor.
I'm a doctor's son. I think I have a little bit more information than you do.
I'm a Doctor Who fan.
This EpiPen controversy. So the EpiPen is such a slap in the face to us as consumers. I mean, if you're gullible enough to vote for Donald Trump, then maybe you're gullible enough to think that, you know, that $100 is fair price for an EpiPen. It probably costs Mylan about $1 or maybe $1.25 to produce that product. I think Bernie said $10. That was very generous because, you know, it's a little self-injector mechanism, which you don't need. I mean, diabetics inject themselves with insulin all the time without a self-injector mechanism. And it's a generic product. Epinephrine is adrenaline. That's in our bodies. It's in the bodies of all vertebrate mammals. And that means all they have to do is extract it out, which is not that difficult. Probably cost them 25 cents for that and another buck I'm giving them for the self-injector, which is not necessary. We're talking $1.25 instead of $300 or what they were originally asking for $700 for two of those injectors. So this is a classic case of being ripped off by monopoly capitalism. And this bill, Prop 61, goes a major step forward in stopping that ripoff by
big
pharma.
But the question is, how else are the pharmaceutical companies going to pay for their 1,300 lobbyists in D.C. that probably make six figures each?
Yeah.
Does this eat into their potential?
Or seven figures.
Yeah. Like, we're talking $1.3 billion on just salaries for the 1,300 just...
I don't know why I wasted my energy trying to be an actor. My parents should have pushed me to be a lobbyist.
You should have been a lobbyist.
$100 million they're spending just to defeat this.
Yeah, you look great in the hallway.
You know, I really appreciate that. I've been trying to be an actor playing a lobby. Whatever. Anyway,
you're doing a great job at that.
Thanks. So is there any the money that the pharmaceutical companies will be losing, does that affect their R&D?
Yeah, that's the one they always drag out, the excuse, the bit of propaganda. So R&D, just so people are clear, are usually done in, say, university settings. So that means a lot of it is by public grants, means it comes from us, you know, as part of a budget, like, say, in NIH. Or it's done overseas in drug company subsidiaries around the world, like places like Japan and Germany, where they do very excellent R&D, research and development, right? So most of that R&D is not done here. And pharmaceutical companies make, and most people aren't aware of this, make between 4 and 5 times the average profits of the Fortune 500 companies. They're 4 or 5 times more profitable than the 500 most profitable companies in the world. So you tell me that all that's going to R&D, you know, right here in the good old US of A or right here in California, I've got a word for that, you know.
Malarkey.
Yeah, malarkey. Baloney.
Baloney.
And then my other question was, Carlos mentioned this on a previous episode, that you could take a vial of epinephrine and just keep it at home and then just inject yourself.
Exactly. And actually most, you know, Bernie, I was at a rally down here on Vine Street last night and with Bernie, and they had a woman come out and describe the horror of having a child who's severely allergic and needing that EpiPen. Most people by far don't need the EpiPen when you're in civilization. You have generally, you know, 20, 30 minutes kind of thing before it turns that serious. Again, as an emergency room doctor, we almost can't say absolutely, but almost never give epi in the emergency room.
Oh, wow.
So what are we giving? We're giving Benadryl or giving, you know, I don't own stock in the company, but, generic is fine. We're giving steroids. We don't give epinephrine. So if we don't give epinephrine, why should you have to? If you can call 911, you know, as long as the person is conscious, is breathing, you know, that kind of thing, looks okay, then you actually don't even need it. So we're being sold a product that, by and large, most of us don't need at some crazy jacked up price.
Well, I think we know where the money is going. It's not R&D. Maybe it's a little bit of PR and advertising.
Exactly.
Yeah, and totally. And coffers. And
so Proposition 61, Dr. Bill, what is your vote?
We vote emphatically yes on Prop 61.
Can I get an emphatic yes from you, Dan?
Hashtag yes on 61.
Yes on 61.
Yes on 61.
It'll twist your arm.
No, I'm with you. I'm with you 100%. Thanks so much.
You're so welcome.
That was...